Guys, welcome back to my channel. I hope everybody is doing well and I hope everyone is staying in the house and keeping safe from this corona, because some of us are gonna be stuck in the house for a while. And yes, your girl is back with another video after a while, but it's okay, we move. I'm gonna try push more content since obviously I have more time in the house. So today I'm gonna do a makeup tutorial. Well, it's kind of a tutorial, but I'm experimenting myself because obviously I put a couple of options up of different types of makeup I could do, and I asked you guys to vote which one you would like me to try. So I'm gonna check which one won and then I'm gonna give it a shot, you know what I'm saying? Because you know, don't expect no makeup guru, makeup artist. I am just learning like everybody else. I'm gonna try, okay? Thank you. And also, I'm going to do a story time. So as I get ready, I will be telling a story. So the look that has won is the Orange Sunset. I'll put it somewhere. That's the one that I'm going to do. And as I'm doing my makeup, I'm gonna share a story with you guys. So I'm going to share the story of how me and my boyfriend Rodney met. So I met him when I was 15. This was when I was still going to school in Zimbabwe. I went to girls college, and yeah, like me and my best friend at the time, you know, we were single, we were living our best lives, like we just wanted to go out there, meet boys, and you know, and we were 15. But anyway, you live once. So we just wanted to get out there and really experience life. So at the time, like there was like a school play at CBC going on, like Christian Brothers College. And yeah, like, you know, she had went and I couldn't go because my parents were really strict and they were like, nah, where are you gonna go? To see what? Have you never seen a play in your life? Where are you going? I was like, okay, then I'll just stay at home. And then she went, and then Monday, when we were back at school, she was telling me, she was like, girl, they're these boys that we need to meet, because Rodney and his dance crew were like dancing in the play, so they were part of it. And obviously she told me like, girl, we need to meet these people. So somehow she ended up talking to one of his brothers and they became good friends. So she organized a link up. And
Before I get too far into the story, I've done my eyebrows, done my concealer under my eyebrows, and I'm putting my foundation on at the moment.
In the picture, she used a dark orange on like the outer part of her eye and then like a really bright orange in the middle. So I'm gonna use my Revolution palette for the darker orange, and then I'm gonna use a different palette for the lighter orange, just before I you know, continue with the story, just to, so people know. So I think I'm probably gonna use that orange, because that's the closest dark orange I have, or either, because I feel like that one's a bit too peachy, so I'll probably use that one.
Now I'm gonna get real up close and personal.
So I'm gonna be looking into my mirror as I do it, and I'm just gonna try and do it on the camera, but I'll try and look at my mirror at the same time. So we all met up, but first like me and her were like waiting for them, so like only one of them pitched up at first because the other one said he was running late. So this is my man's pulling out. Your girl is nervous as hell, and my friend is like, oh, like go say hi as he was walking up, and I was like, no, I'm not doing that, no. And she's like, just go, and she pushed me. So obviously I'm under pressure now and I have to go hug this guy that I don't even know. He's looking fine. I'm just like, okay, I really had to brace myself, and I hugged him. I was like, hi, and then like obviously I was shy, and oh, honestly I was a mess that day. And then we just started walking around the neighborhood, hanging out, stuff like that, talking. So I wasn't talking much because I was shy, like I did not know what I was doing, like I was confused, I was just mesmerized by his gorgeousness, you know. Guys, I'm gonna use this palette. I kind of lost the lid, so I can't remember what it's called, and I'm gonna use this orange because I feel like it's the closest one to like brighten up in the middle part. So yeah, your girl is nervous. I don't know, I just wasn't myself. And then obviously I start getting comfortable slowly, bit by bit. We start talking a bit more. He's really like intrigued to get to know me and stuff like that. So so we're walking and yeah, it was almost time for me to start going home. So we started walking in the direction of my house because he doesn't live like too far from where I live. So we started walking in the direction like of my house, and like this is like after like his brother had came and we're chilling, and obviously I didn't deep it too much. I was just like, oh my gosh, he's so cute, like let's go where we're going please, because this girl is like And then like yeah, like now I'm comfortable, I'm talking to the guy, and at the time I was chewing gum, right? And like I got sick of the gum and like I threw it away, and like Rodney's literally dying of laughter, and I'm like, what is he laughing at? Like, what is funny? Like, I don't get it. And he's literally dying, and I'm just like, did I do something wrong? What's funny? Like, is there something on my face? And he was just like, nah, like just the way you threw away that gum was just hilarious. And for him, he always says like that's when he really saw my character and my personality really come out, just from throwing away my gum. And I'm like, you're such a weirdo, but I love it. So yeah, like we started talking more, and from that day onwards, you know, he asked me for my number and he was like, we should talk, and I was just like, okay, cool. Okay, so guys, I'm trying. Your girl is trying. Like, I'm just trying to see, like, is it enough orange? I feel like it is. Obviously that girl's like, was that like a neon orange? I don't really have a neon orange, but like this is the closest I can get to it. But I'm actually okay with this, it's not terrible. So for the gold, I'm gonna use my Kylie palette. Sorry guys, in the state of, I've had it for years, and I'm gonna use this gold. I've added the gold. I don't know if you guys can see it, but yeah, I've tried. Your girl is trying. But yeah, continuing with the story. So obviously we started talking, we started to get to know each other. And yeah, like we became really good friends, like we were really close, like we were seeing each other pretty often, and yeah, like we were just cool with each other, like we had no issues, we just really vibed, you know. And we were friends for about 2 years before we started dating, because I felt like, well, he felt like it wasn't the time for us to date at that time. Well, initially, like, you know, because we're still seeing like other people, like there was nothing, we never like saw each other in that light until obviously we got to a point where like, why are we with people that don't deserve us, like, you know. The concealer that I use for under my eyebrows and everything is the Rimmel Match Perfection one. That's the one that I use for, you know, contour, concealing, all of that, honey, all of that. I feel like the way our friendship grew and like where we were at that time, like we did kind of like need each other, because I felt like if I didn't have Rodney in my life at that time, I would be a whole different person. Like I would not be the person that I am today, because I feel like as I've grown, he's taught me a lot and I've taught him a lot. It's kind of been vice versa, like we've always been 100 with each other. We'll be honest with each other, like if we don't like something or if something is going on that we feel uncomfortable with or anything like that. So it made the relationship much easier because we had established that in the friendship. And honestly, like obviously at first when we started dating, I was like, oh, I'm so used to you being my friend. Do I hold your hand? Do I kiss you? Do I call you babe? What do I do? Like, you know, it was just difficult at the first time, but once we got into the groove of it, life was easy, life was great. And so I've glued my eyelashes on and I'm baking my face at the moment, so just my hair that's left to do, and then your girl gonna be done. I don't think it looks that bad. I'm gonna big up myself and be like, good effort. So yeah, that is the story of how me and Rodney met. So yeah, you know, I'll give you more juicy stories to come in the near future. But yeah guys, let's talk about corona. This corona thing, guys, I feel like
Yeah, God is punishing us. God is punishing us. Let's not lie. You know, that's what I feel like personally. I feel like this is the time for people to get closer to God if you're a Christian, or people who are not Christians to know God better maybe. And like, you know, like, guys, check on your loved ones, please. You know, be that support. Just call someone and be like, I hope you're okay. Like, honestly, like, that makes such a big difference. Like, honestly. But yeah, as I was saying, I feel like in a way, like, this time is for people to just, you know, work on themselves and really reconnect with maybe family or like obviously God. Like, I'm not gonna lie, like, ever since like this corona thing started, I've been reading my Bible more, I've been praying more, and like after this I feel like I'm not gonna be like a different person, but I feel like this experience has definitely been an eye-opening one. And like life is short. Like, the amount of people that have passed away because of this corona is really sad. And because, like, obviously it's such a contagious, like, virus, like, people can't even go to their loved ones' funerals. And like, it's just, oh, honestly, it breaks my heart just thinking about it. Yeah, guys, the message I've got from this whole experience is just, life is short. Live your life, live your best life. Like, do whatever you want to do, achieve the things you want to do. I'm not saying like do illegal things, nah, but just like live your life, live a simple life, you know. After this, trust me, I'm going to be ticking off my bucket list. I will be ticking off that bucket list, like, bro, like, there's so many things I want to do, but you know, I always like tell myself, no, I have enough time. No, we really don't have that much time on this earth. And yeah, I'd also like to give like thanks to all the doctors. Like, they're really doing the most out here in hospitals, but not just doctors, like anyone who's helping within this situation, nurses, like caretakers, stuff like that. Like, big ups to you guys. You guys are really like being exposed to the coronavirus more than anyone else, but you're still like doing it for people. And clap for the NHS, but not just the NHS, like other countries as well that are going through this. Like, it's hard, guys. But yes, oh, I'm almost done. So guys, this is the final look. I don't think I did too much of a bad job, but you know, your girl tried. And yeah, I'm happy with it, you know. But yes, please don't forget to like and subscribe the video, and I will put the details of the makeup products that I use at the bottom in the description box. And guys, stay home, stay safe, wash your hands. Love you all. Bye.